Today, guys, we're going to be stocking my brand new shark pond with my brand new horn shark in there, full of exotic fish and sea creatures. Now, the brand new horn shark is absolutely thriving in here, and he's not even eating any of the glass minnows that we put in there. So we have an opportunity to have a full-blown reef in this shark pond. We got fish and sharks, maybe some stingrays. You never know what we can get for that pond. Now, let's start with bucket number one. We're gonna go from least expensive to most expensive, and we have a really, really cool fish at the end of this video that I personally have never had before, who's gonna really swim around and look amazing in that pond. Now, guys, the first bucket, I wanted to get some free swimming fish, just like the glass minnows, except more fish with brighter colors. And these guys are bright blue chromies. They are amazing with sharks. We've had a tank in the past with sharks and chromies only, and it looked so good. So I'm gonna start with just three of them this time, and we can slowly add to the population as we go. But three of them is the magic number right now. I just wanna see how they look in the pond, how their colors turn out, and how they do with our brand new shark in there. Now let's get them in the pond. Look at the colors on these guys. They're bright green and blue. Those are such cool colors. I love these little chromies. Guys, we can get a ton of different kinds of them. We can get these chromies, we can get the bright royal blue ones. They're just a really cool fish to have in the pond, especially when they're gonna be swimming around right next to that shark. Now let's get them in. Now here we go, guys. The little chromies, they're gonna swim out of this net. They're gonna see that shark, they're probably gonna dart right for that rock. Check them out, they're really, really cool. They're gonna school together. Oh, those are awesome. Look how bright their colors look. I have to get more of these guys. Three is not enough. Drop a like on this video if I should get like 20 of them and just put them, load them up all in this pond. I think that would look amazing with those green colors and get some royal blue ones. That would be really cool. But as you guys can see, the chromies just look so much better than the glass minnows. Like, we have a bunch of glass minnows in here, but imagine if they were all bright green, bright blue chromies and damsels. It would look so good in this pond to have a bunch of fish swimming around like that. Now on to bucket number two. I just had to grab this guy because the store had a tank they wanted to get rid of and this guy was in them. It was just one peppermint shrimp left and I just said, you know what? You guys give me a deal. They gave it to me for $2. I got this peppermint shrimp for it. I absolutely love peppermint shrimp. They're native here in Florida, so they're everywhere. We can catch them and they're always super cheap at the store. This guy I really got because I am gonna actually see if the horn shark wants to eat him because the horn shark is very picky. Right now he's only eating squid, so I'm gonna see if he likes live shrimp instead. That way if we wanna catch a bunch of shrimp and feed it to him, we can do that as well. Now let's get this guy in the pond. Now these guys are super cool. They're called peppermint shrimp or candy cane shrimp for a reason. They got those red beautiful stripes that run down the back and they're really cool. Now I'm gonna see if the shark eats him, but I'm gonna put him on the rock. So if he lives well in this tank, he's gonna do great. But if the shark gets hungry, I'm okay with him having a $2 shrimp as a meal. So let's get our brand new candy cane shrimp in the pond. I'm gonna put him right, look at him. He wants to stay on my hand. He's gonna stay on my hand and crawl all over it. That's hilarious. Honestly, I wouldn't be mad getting a bunch of these guys as well, but I do know the sharks, especially the horn sharks, they love crystal. And I want to make sure that this guy's fed at all times. So nibbling on one shrimp isn't gonna hurt. So let's try to get this guy by the rock here because he really wants to stay on my hand. He really wants to stay on my hand. He will not leave my hand. There you go, buddy. Stay by that rock. So there he is on that nice new purple rock we got for him. And the shark may smell him out, may get a nice meal out of him. But if he does well on that rock, that's okay too. Now guys, let's move on to bucket number three, but I gotta give a shout out to Samuel who commented, name the shark Reef. So that's officially his name. I really like that name. It's a really cool name. We're gonna name the horn shark Reef. So we officially have Reef the Horn Shark in the mini pond. If you guys wanna name these fish that I'm about to show you, go ahead, drop those names in the comments so we can name all the fish that we get in today's video. Now, next bucket is a really cool fish that's gonna keep everything healthy because they are technically doctors, guys. They are the doctors of the fish world. And this guy is a beautiful blue and Carolina blue cleaner wrasse. These guys are super cool because they swim around like crazy and they really, really help the fish. They're called cleaner wrasse for a reason. They go around, they pick some stuff off the fish and they just keep them nice and clean and healthy. And it's a really good idea to have multiple of these guys in the pond. So I may end up putting some more of these guys in here because I want this to be a true reef environment, just like Reef the horn shark. Now look at the beautiful, gorgeous colors on this little wrasse here. He's bright blue and that dark royal blue on his tail there. He's even got a little yellow and gold on his head and he looks really, really cool and vibrant in here. That's the whole goal for today, is getting vibrant fish to make this feel like a reef. So let's get this awesome little dude in the pond and see how he looks in there. Now these guys are super slippery. I gotta be really careful with these guys. They are super, super cool. He will jump right out of my hand if I'm not careful. So watch this, guys. He's gonna dart right off, probably right towards that rock. He's gonna be so cool in here. He's gonna swim around like crazy. That is awesome. He's just such a cool little wrasse. I absolutely love these guys. We might have to name him Dr. Wrasse, guys. Not gonna lie, this guy might already have a name already. Extremely cool fish with those colors. He's going right up to those chromies. He looks amazing in here. And we're really brightening up this pond. We got our awesome shark, who literally doesn't eat fish, so that's perfect. And we got our awesome colorful fish to go along with it. I got a really, really colorful, really cool fish coming up in bucket number 5. But let's move on to bucket number 4. Now everyone go do me a favor in the comments and drop a comment below of what your most colorful fish is that you have in your aquarium. I'd love to look them up. I always love looking up your guys' suggestion. And maybe we can get one of those colorful fish that you leave in the comments for our brand new shark aquarium. That would be really, really cool. So let's move on to bucket number 4. These are a must in any aquarium. So what I got here is 5 emerald crabs. I always get them in these stocking videos because they are just so healthy and good for the tanks, especially with a horn shark who loves eating crustaceans. So now he has options. He can go for that shrimp, he can go for the squid I give him, and he can go for these emerald crabs. They'll keep the tank clean, and he has a food source to eat because reef, the horn shark, is my number one priority, guys. He's my number one priority. I want him to be completely comfortable, completely fed and healthy in every video that I post so we can enjoy him for a really long time. Hopefully move him to the giant saltwater pond eventually. So let's get these green emerald crabs in the pond. Look at this guy. This guy's riding piggyback on this big crab. That's hilarious. These emerald crabs are so funny. They always crawl on top of each other, and they're really, really cool crabs, honestly. They help the aquarium, and Reef's gonna love these guys to munch on them. Hopefully he doesn't go after the one with the big claws, because he might bite back, and Reef might get a little scared. So let's drop these guys in. I'm curious to see if Reef will go right up to them and actually eat them. That would be really cool to show you guys. Now, I'm not gonna put these guys on the rock. I'm actually gonna put them right in the open here. Let's see if Reef will swim by them and check them out and see if he wants to eat one here. That would be super cool to catch on camera. Oh, Reef feels something. Now, horn sharks are really notorious for biting their food and then spitting it out and then coming back for it later, so I think that's what he might do. Now, guys, my favorite bucket of the day. This fish is so freaking cool. He literally looks like a dolphin, like a literal dolphin. This fish is a giraffe. I think it's a giraffe wrasse? Totally forgot the name of this fish. I'm gonna call him the giraffe wrasse. I'm not sure if that's correct. I think I have something confused in my head, but this thing is extremely cool. Swims around like crazy. He's bright green and blue. So cool. I do want to get him a different wrasse at the store that I saw. It was a female wrasse. It was bright white that they said goes really well with these guys. So I might do that in a future video. But this guy is amazing. He's got a really long nose. Very, very unique fish. So we're definitely going to need a name for this guy. He's ridiculously cool. Let's see what he looks like in the pond, under the light, under the water. Let's get him in there. That is so cool, guys. That's insane. That is such a cool fish. Look at his nose like that. That is so cool. 2 wrasses going in the pond today. That is such an awesome looking fish. Look at the green on him, that bright blue tail in the back, the purple tail. Then he's got all this neon, all this dark kind of foresty green right there all along him there. Let's get him in the pond. He's so freaking cool. I always see these guys in the store and I never pull trigger on them, but I've had to do it today. Let's go. That is so cool. Now these guys like to bury in the sand. Now as you can see him in this pond, he's already darting around like crazy. Both the wrasse are just swimming around like nuts in here. They don't stop moving. That's why I wanted to get them today. Bright fish for the pond, and he looks really good in here. He's a lot bigger than the cleaner wrasse, but he is a lot cooler as well. So he's kind of following the shark around a little bit and swimming with him, so it's really, really cool to see that. And that wrasse is just a great new addition for the saltwater pond. He looks awesome in here. I'm so stoked to see and watch him grow and get nice and big. Now, our next bucket is another extremely cool fish, and we went with a theme here today, guys. We went with the wrasse, and we went with the colors. This guy pretty much has every color of the rainbow on him. He's pink, he's neon green, he's got a little blue in there, a little yellow. He is super cool. Another wrasse on the bigger side, which is good as well, who will also help clean up the tank, clean up the scraps, and swim around in this pond and make everything just pop in here. So let's get our awesome rainbow wrasse, rainbow colored wrasse, in the new shark pond. Look at that fish, guys. That is so cool. Literally neon green and pink right here, all down his scales. You see those scales? All have a hint of neon green, blue, pink. Insanely cool. Look how calm he's being right now. He's being so chill, being so calm. Look at him in the light there. That's just insane, the colors on him. Insane. Pink tail. I'm loving the wrasse recently, guys. Got a whole bunch of them today, and they just look so good. They're all gonna be swimming around together. It's gonna be amazing. Let's get this dude in the new shark pond. All right, guys, another wrasse for you. Another wrasse, so cool. Now these guys definitely bury into the sand, so he might just go right into the sand or right into that rock. Oh, yep, he just went right into the sand. He just buried right into the sand right here. He's in that sand right there. I don't know if I got on the GoPro, but he just dipped right into the sand. That's crazy. Dang it, guys, I wanted to get a cool clip on the GoPro for you guys, but he got a little scared once we put him in the pond, and he went right underneath that sand. But I'm sure as the days go by, he'll come right out and swim around like a beast. Awesome day of stalking today, guys. This shark pond is my heart and soul right now. It is absolutely amazing. It's literally my favorite one in here now because we have Reef the shark in there. And I'm in the works of getting some more sharks. I'm talking to some people, doing some emails, trying to get some more sharks for us. So stay tuned for those videos. Remember, guys, go get yourself an awesome Fish Guy shirt at fishguy.shop. We just restocked the Respect the Reef shark hats. So go check those out. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.